What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 301, Make It Songbringer. Today I'm going to be working on some lights for the new ant dungeon. These are ant people. They're human descendants. Millions of years ago in the Milky Way galaxy, humans populated the galaxy, seeded all these planets. This is one of the planets that they came from was this ant planet. It's got these ant people. I drew some more ant people this morning, working on this ant dungeon. What's up, Arcane? Hey, guys. So here's kind of what the ant female I'm thinking looks like. What's up, Chewy and Pedro? How you guys doing? Yeah, so I'm working on some code right now that makes it so the lights are loaded from data. So I'm working on these lights right now. I'm gonna get them to flicker. I'm gonna change their color. I'm gonna change their brightness and change how they look and add an animation. You can't really see them, but they're supposed to float too. So they're on these little floating pillars. So yeah, I'm just working on these. What's up, Artemis? Welcome to the stream, all y'all. Hope you're having a good day. So the thing is, I kind of want it to look like it used to. It used to have this oval light thing. Oh, it said blend funk additive. That's right. Additive. What's up, Boogie? Yeah, and then it runs this action. It flickers it. But the big thing here is additive. I think render components can be additive. Yeah, just data get child additive. That's right. So I'm gonna go to the entities. Stream's buffering a lot. Looks like it's running okay. Oh, yeah, I'm working on lights and stuff. Now it's frozen. Damn. I hope it gets better. Doesn't seem like an internet issue. I'm working on the ant dungeon still, so I'm working on these lights. Yeah, Pedro, it's the way the new settings are for my internet. I have a horrible internet and all that lately. So, yeah, they still haven't fixed it. So I have to change up my, settings. And that's why you see all these drop frames, because I have to limit the maximum bit rate for it to not be able to upload too much. So, you know, that's why you see a lot of drop frames on my end. It's just because it can't export this whole, you know, retina quality screen to you guys at anything more than 2000 kbps. But it's also recording too, so it records in high definition for YouTube, and then it exports to Twitch at a lower bit rate. So that's why you see this drop thing. It shows a lot of drop frames because it can't quite keep up with the quality because of the bitrate. Oh, it's fine for you? All right, good. What's up, Hardboiled? Yeah, so I'm just working on lights. I'm working on these lights and making them more data-driven. This is really, really great because once these are totally data-driven, so like I'm gonna make these lights here flicker, I'm gonna change their color, change their brightness and all this stuff and get these things to float. Basically just create some really cool looking lights for this ant style dungeon. So one thing was that the light was additive before. I'm gonna change that to additive. I'm just modifying data at this point and then hooking up methods so that it does. Yeah, there, that looks a little bit more. Yeah, Cool. All right. So additive, let's get it flickering too. Has light flag flicker. So I can go ahead and add a flicker action to it. If the light entity actually, I'll just get the light. Light entity get light component it any stop back. If the light has the flicker. Then do this flicker action thing. You'll probably need to change up these parameters and stuff too. Oh, I need to grab the render too. What? Only 6,000 sales on the first day for the witness? Yeah, I know. I noticed that too about the $40. I was like, oh, let's go buy it. Let's go buy it totally. And then I was like, oh, it's $40. What? Okay, that just changed it completely. You can tell. Because the flicker is really low. So I do need to, man, I do need to make this all data driven too. All these light flickering flags. Manic, thanks for hosting. What's up, too? All right, so yeah, let's make this flicker totally data driven. That means also it's not going to need this light. All right, so flicker. A lot of settings here. I don't even know what half of them are. Flicker create duration, min opacity, max opacity, blah, blah, blah. Let's figure out how to make all this data, express all this data. Entities. Okay, so I'm hooking up a new way to make a light flicker. Really, it's running on the render component. I'll call it an action. Flicker action. I guess just flickers. And then duration 90. You just finished your own session for the witness? What's up, Unreal? Turn screen from player to player. Oh, you're working on your game. Oh, sweet, man. Nice. Yeah, I know. That's how it goes, right? With bugs and all that. You do one little change, then you got a bug. So, opacity. Express this as a range. We got it currently as an integer, min opacity 32. Let's make that a float. So 32, 255 becomes 0.125. Upper end of the range, 40, 0.157. There, we got an opacity range, now scale range, min scale, max scale. I think that's X and Y. Yeah, we got min scale X, max scale X, min scale Y, max scale Y. So this is scale X, scale Y. And then we got color, min color, and max color. I guess we could, yeah, color minimum 252, 168, 50. It becomes FCA 832 through 255, 160. Oh, same color. Nice. So I can just do the color range like that. Yay, now I can parse all this and we're gonna have a flicker action running from a render component completely from data. You're having quite a bad day? Well, let me entertain you, my friend. Let me entertain you with programming and pixel art. I'm going to make some pixel art, too. Here's the ant female I was working on today. This is with some brighter colors. She's got a nice complementary color. I'm thinking instead of a gun, they might shoot these energy beam type things from their palms. I don't know. There's one pose. Here's another pose of her, like just standing. Murphy's Law for gaming. If the final build can crash, it will. Ah, Murphy's Laws. Program pixel art and backflips? You want backflips too? Nice, man. I'm glad you like the pixel art. I don't know. I can't do no backflips though right now. I need to be studying my backflipping technology. Figure that out. I need some rocket boosters for that. Now all of this can be just expressed from data. So in the render component, we just run an action straight when we're done creating it. Render component, set data, blah, blah, blah. Actions, flicker. This is if we have a flicker. So auto ref flicker equals data.getChild. Flicker. If flicker isn't null. Read in these properties. And then run the action, which we got from area creation. It's like this, where it renders this action, flicker action. So yeah, we're gonna parse this data and then run this. What's up, Azenris? What's up, Scottish Pizza? Nice, glad you like the ant people. They're gonna get better and better. There's a lot more art to do. There's a lot more to come this week. So for the next 4 weeks, this is kind of my general plan. 1 week I'm going to work on a dungeon. Actually, 2 of the weeks I'm going to work on 2 new dungeons. So, but hopefully by beta, there'll be 2 brand new dungeons with complete bosses, enemies, music, basically just enough to kind of have 2 more dungeons. And then 1 of the weeks I'm actually going to work on the intro. So I'm going to work on the first initial cutscenes of the game, so you actually will set up the story finally, and that way I can also do a better video. So by the time I do beta launch February 21, it'll have a better video up with a little bit more story in it, and maybe, you know, it's basically the story elements mixed with how the current video is. All right, so duration, that's an easy one. Duration equals flicker dot get child duration. Git float. We're going to be passing to, so we got a vec2 opacity range. Parse vec from data or Flickr dot get child. Oops. Opacity. Parse that into opacity range. Delimiter is a dash. Keep your fingers crossed, yeah. Things just went right in a way I did not expect. Isn't that great? Serendipity. This is dot getster. Alright, so we're also gonna parse two more vectors of scale. Scale X 1.0, 1.0, scale Y. All right, so parsing these vectors, scale X. So for anybody just joining the stream, what I'm doing right now is I'm making lights data-driven. So I can express a light completely in data, and therefore I can switch to new dungeons and have new dungeons that have the completely different kind of lights. All right, and then the color range also needs to be parsed. That's going to be vector string colors. And then color 3B, we'll do color RGB. There we go. All right, so we'll go split. You only got 17 hours on Songbringer? Man, that's a lot. You just want to get these tiles done so you get back to programming? What, you working on tiles? Cool. You got 30 hours? Wow. Man, Hardboiled, thank you so much for all your great feedback too. Hardboiled's been playing the game like crazy, recording it. And sending me videos of like the important like little bugs. Like, it was so nice and helpful to have a video to be able to see like, why did this switch turn on too soon, when the, you know, it's like, oh, I can fix that pretty easy. So thanks, Hardboiled, really appreciate it. And thank you everybody else for playing the game too, of course. Like, y'all, it's so helpful to have you guys' feedback and everything listed on Trello nice and stuff. I'm thinking I probably will update the Steam build maybe like once a week for the next month, you know, like just try and get in some like good fixes. And I'm trying to keep things separate too. So I got two branches, like I got the fun branch and then the master branch. Basically the master branch is going to be the code that I can just check into the Steam build. So this, the, like, I'm kind of keeping my master branch and as the release branch, you know, and that way I can kind of, I can do all these fun things like adding new lights and all this rad stuff, but not quite apply it to the master branch until it's ready to be tested. You know, I have to test things a little bit first. But some things I can easily go and switch to the master branch and make a quick few changes to the release build so I can push out some bug fixes without having to test all this huge stuff that I've changed in the fun branch. So, long story short, you guys will get a few updates this month rather than like last time where I would wait months until I updated the Steam build. Whoa, 250 on Binding of Isaac? Man. That's awesome. I'm glad. Okay, so split. Skyrim, yeah, I'm sure Skyrim, yep, way up there. There we go, yeah, so split the flickr.get child color delimiter dash as well into the color stirs. Why didn't that work? Oh, always keep forgetting this. There we go. All right, ready to run this action. This is the sprite.setOpacity, sprite.runAction. And we can plug in all these numbers. Duration. Opacity range. Opacity, there. Times 255. Whoa. 247? So, Boogie, what was it about Skyrim that it just wasn't your style? What was missing? What did you want out of your game? Scale X. This is scale X. Here we go. Hopefully this works. Just not patient enough, too much walking. Oh, yeah. Yeah. It totally depends, right? It depends on who you are, what you prefer. I never got into like World of Warcraft or any of those games where it would seem like too much grinding to me. I don't know. I didn't really want to spend so much time playing World of Warcraft. So I tried it, but I just never really got into it because it was kind of like too slow for me. And not 2D enough for me. I really love 2D. Okay, great. We got this all. Hopefully this is all now expressed just nicely in the data there. And I can comment this out. Ooh, that's nice. Get rid of all this code. Okay, let's see if that worked with the flicker. Skyrim Walking Simulator. The Witness Walking Simulator. Really? How are the puzzles, though? Witness is like real, looks really, really puzzly. I'm sure it's really good. Duration, 90 seconds. All right, great. That parsed correctly. Let's see how these other things parse. Opacity. No, I mean opacity range scale. Yeah, opacity. Yeah, that's what opacity range is supposed to be. 0.125 to 0.157. Scale X, scale Y. Split the colors, parse the colors. Let's see what the second RGB function gets passed as a string. Stir FCA, yep, 832. Cool. That should parse correctly. And the sprite just runs the action. Duration, opacity range, X, Y. Scale X, scale Y, color 0, colors 1. Yes, this is looks good. Awesome. And where the hell was that breakpoint? Come back to the breakpoint. I want to delete you. Mars Power always wanted me to do that. Drag the breakpoints away. The puzzles are nice. Just drag lines across mazes, but there's lots of different symbols in each maze. You have to take mental notes. Cool. We got flickering lights. You never like MMOs? Not enough pixel art? Oh man, hard boiled. Man after my own heart. I'm the same way, man. I love pixel art and I love 2D. What about if virtual walking entails real walking? Lazarus, you might have the next game. Do it, man. You like 3D more? See, there you go. Yeah, everybody's got their thing. They also use physical properties, shadows of trees. Yeah, I saw one thing in there. There's like lights going through the laser beams almost going through the sky. Right, let's mess with this light and make it really bright and crazy. That's the original flicker. Let's play with the flicker a lot, like especially its opacity. Let's go with a really, really bright opacity. So we can see it clearly where it's at. Whoa, yeah, definitely you can see where it's at. So something happened, it actually got offset. That's like a little bit too bright to even debug. I'm like, oh my God, I can't look at those lights. Pixels, man, pixels. Okay, so there's one problem with these lights. They're offset. They're like pushed up into the sky a bit. And why is that? Oh, I just realized what it is. It's its anchor point. Oh man, the render components. Like, can I set their anchor points? Opacity, color type. Oh, anchor point. Let's set the anchor point here. So where do we call said data? And I think it might overwrite that because it calls add sprite. Oh, dang! It calls said data after. I got it. So the sprite could have an anchor point. It's all messed up at first. Or just default, I guess. Default. Now it needs to be something distinct. So sprite could start with. So it calls set sprite, but then it calls set data. Oh, it does call set sprite first. Oh yeah, so I can override. Oh duh. But later it calls add sprite, which is where oh it just adds the sprite. Oh, alright. Okay, so anchor point. It can definitely be set the anchor point here. Oh, this is a dungeon. Yeah, this is a new dungeon I'm working on. They're more supposed to be stone tiles. Yeah, they look kind of reddish right now. I'm not sure if they're I need to edit them a little bit. Ingress, this is the walking game. Walking game. There we go. Set an anchor point with data. Bam. Let's see if that works. So, there. Back here in entities. It's got an image, but I want the anchor for this one to be 0.5, 0.5 instead of its usual 0.50. Happy Moose, thank you for the happy 300. Today you were paid for the first time to sing on someone's song? Whoa! Nice. Yeah, I know, that's right, 301 days. Actual development days, 301 total live streams so far. Okay, so that was great. The anchor point was in the right place. Now if I move the anchor upward, let's see what happens if I go all the way to the top. Oh, that should anchor it to the top, which would mean the light will be below this thing. A 301 BC warrior train? Is that even possible? Of course it's possible. Yeah, and if I go zero, or how about negative 0.5? It works. Cool. So I want this to stay at 0.5. Yes. So that's like from the offset of the light. So light, nah, we shouldn't do the light offset here. We should do position. We Yeah, so this whole light will have a position that moves its render component and its other component up in the air. Let's go like 30, see if we can tweak that. Yeah, let's go even higher, 60. Quick question regarding memory allocation. For practice, I'm still fairly new to C++. I'm writing associative array class. Associative array class. Do you mean a map? You're writing like a map? Associative array. That means like the keys or strings. I'm writing associative array class and the handling hash. Collisions by linking? The class has an allocator for the initial array, but I'm unsure if I should use the allocator or new for allocating a single node containing the key value pointer to the next item. Ooh, man, I don't know. I don't know, man. I'm not that much of a C++ genius, but I would think you'd probably want to use the allocator, definitely not new. Because you want, if you've written something with an allocator, you want to use the allocator, man. Otherwise, just delete your allocator and use new. But maybe I'm thinking about that too simple. I don't know, man. I hope that helps. What's up, Brega? Yeah, you're here, dude. You're here for it. All right, so yeah, I'm working on this new dungeon here with these flickering lights and all this stuff. I'm working on a new dungeon, but in the process of working on this dungeon, I'm working on making lights able to be expressed through data. So I'm working on this whole flicker thing, and let's see if I change the color of this whole. Let's turn off. I'm going to turn this off completely, actually, for a moment and move on to the next step. But actually, it was pretty cool seeing it, yeah, without the flicker like this. Yeah, it's kind of neat seeing these bright lights. But I kind of wish I still wish they flickered a little bit. Let's play with that. So let's keep its opacity. Actually, we can do a random opacity between 1 and 0, duration 90, scale 1, 1. Actually, you can go up to like 1.1 maybe. Yeah, and then 1 to 1.1, color white. Repeater's a cheater. We definitely don't have enough people for a 301 train. Nope. There we go. Now we got a flickering effect that can work with different kinds of lights. That's cool. Man, never. No! Opacity is flickering too much there, though. So let's go 0.8 to 0.9. Maybe it should be slower too. Let's see what it's like when it's a real slow flicker. I think I want it to go all the way to 1. Oh no, how'd you get your messages deleted? There we go. Now I'm going to make this slightly the orange color of the ant people. Slight, maybe like that. FFFA2. Fake band? Is it possible to fake band? That's looking pretty cool. I want them to float though. And they should be able to have an animation. And the create light function. Oh yeah, let's get the old light working as well with this new system. So this will be the four light. We'll start with that, like four light. Turn that off. This will be the zero light with this other flicker. Okay, so we should still have that old four light. I kind of want to see that flicker even less. 0.05 maybe. What's up, Akuma? You like the ants? Yeah, I'm really excited to put the ants in here. They'll be cool enemies. Alright, so I'm gonna go back to level 1 and make sure the old fire light is working. In fact, it won't at first. There won't be any flames, but there should be a light. Oh no, he got his messages deleted again. Oh, hardboiled dude, you're just getting the short end of the stick today, man. I'm sure we're all sorry though. 600 seconds. Okay, yeah, so that light needs to have, wait, it was still flickering a little. But now it needs the actual flame part of it, which should be like a separate animation, different little entity. Yeah, you can see a little bit of orange flicker going on. It's very subtle. Okay, so let's get hooked up with, back in area creation, where it's creating a light. This is cool. We got rid of one component completely now. So we don't need that. Now we don't need this. Ooh, look at that. Lights used to have a different anchor point. 0.4. Oh yeah, but that can now be changed with the actual position offset. So here, if I turn this back on, we'll have some fire again. It's going good, Kuma. But not great for hardboiled. Why me? Oh, that was the additive part of the animation. Let's turn back on the actual part of the fire. Banning is not the answer. It's research. Yeah, all right. We got some flames now, but let's now I got to make this data driven, so there will no longer be all of this code. All of this will fall to the wayside. Okay, so if I were to do this with data only, first thing I would start with is having light have a child with also within a position offset and also with a render component that was just fire zero to start with. No light, that's it, just render. No way. The witness is the walking simulator. I didn't call that. Did somebody else call that? I'm on the stream for the last couple weeks or so, but I haven't gamed since December. Yeah, it's true. You've had it for a while, huh? You played the old alpha. Right, so this should have had a child entity light right here. It didn't. Image, maybe it's not the. That is that right? Fire zero. What's up, AnoaNet? Yo. Hardboiled egg didn't do anything wrong. Oh, it's added. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right. Old gradient. Why doesn't it have a child? Children. Did I do children wrong? Child. Oh, each one of these children needs a name. That's right. There we go. Children. This is the fire entity. That's right. You got something here since October? Some people have it since. When do people have it? June? I think June was the first one. Happy Moose. Yeah, this is a custom format, but I released it on GitHub. It's called Valtry. So if you go to GitHub, NatWeez, that's a I think oh yeah, Bapu already had it, dude. Oh yeah, thanks, Boogie. You already linked to it. But yeah, that's the data format. Yo, what's up, Stadoff? All he did want to do was start a trade. Quit picking on hard-boiled. Render Z order. I guess it's Z order, huh? Yeah, it's a separate entity, so this thing also needs to be high. Z order high. Plus 79999. Probably 8,000. Make sure it's on. Well, no, 7999. So that's okay. So that should put the flame on top. Next, we need to animate it. Yes, cool. We got a single static flame on top. So next thing needs to be make it so it runs that animation. Can I just change that to fire pound sign? Yeah, the roots. That's German last name. Yeah, thanks, Foo, or I mean, Moose. Nice, Boogie. Thanks, man. Yes, I'm glad. I agree. I think Valtry is just super cool because, Jason has a few extra characters that I don't want to see all the time, and Jason's harder to parse, and Valtry is really simple, really fast. Okay, so that didn't work with the fire pound sign, but what if it was a fire percent D? Your name has Irish roots? What? Really? Then I know we are pronouncing it wrong. Yes. It's actually Weiss. My last name is pronounced Weiss in German. But ever since one of my great grandparents came over to the United States, they started pronouncing our last name Weiss. And that's just kind of, you know, in honor of my father, I continue to call it Weiss. But Weiss. You can say Weiss. You can call me Weiss. So I'm Nat Weiss. I think it's pretty cool. Fire percent D. So that did work, huh? Oh, but it only did one frame because it just picked one random. So I need to do an animation. I forget how to do an animation with render components. You never knew pizza was an Irish word? Yeah, Nat Vice, dude. It'd be cool to, right? It's like Miami Vice or Archer Vice. Render component. Where is it? It loads an animation. An M. There it is. There's only one case where it actually would automatically animate. There it is. If contains percent in the name. I believe it parses the percent earlier. No, it doesn't actually. I'm just going to look for the word fire. What have I got for the data? It's fire zero. I want that to be fire percent D. I want to just walk through why that's not loading an animation. No one's going to ban you, I promise. If they ban you, it'll be like a serious talking to. Yeah, thanks, Adolf. Thanks for saying that. I appreciate you saying that. That's awesome. I'm glad you like the open source projects I've been releasing over the last... Man, I've been releasing a lot of open source projects over the last few years. Rapid Game, Valtree, EntityFoo. All these are, like, pretty proud of. Especially Rapid Game. I did this all this rad stuff to Rapid Game, so now it's finally can build Linux. I actually got everything ready, so... So the beta version of Songbringer will run on Linux. Thoughts on the main character? What's this main character? Oh, what it should be? What your main character should be? Looks like, I don't know, to go with the rest of your art style, I would pick the character that kind of goes well somehow. I don't know, male, female? I don't know. What do I end up using for keyboard and controller handling? I use this open source library called OIS. It's if you just look for OIS source forge. Yeah, it's a great library. It's really simple. It's cross-platform, C++, really easy to modify. I like it. They did a good job on this. Oh, you asked about the menu? Oh, you said main screen, and I thought you wrote main character. Sorry, man, I'm a little bit tired. The menu, just about the menu. Oh. I like it a lot. Personally, if I were to change the artwork, the only thing I would change is to take the black. There's a lot of black on the one game jam. And there's a lot of black on the logo, make or break the routine. There's also a little bit of black with the buttons, continue, new game, and options. But nowhere in the rest of your scene are you using black. The rest of the scene uses some darker browns and stuff. And I don't know, I kind of think the black looks a little out of place myself. So if I were to change anything about the art of this, I would simply just take the black and make it a darker brown, just like the other deeper colors in this scene, to give it more flow. Right now, it looks like the one game a month, one jam, and the logo are sort of out of place. And I guess that's probably sort of intentional, but I think that doing the opposite, where you kind of blend them together, is a really nice aesthetic. But that's just my aesthetic, so that's my thoughts on that. Gain put, huh? So I confused everybody? Yeah, but so what? Why do you have to have their official logo? Does it matter? You can just change the logo a little tiny bit. Cool, nice, animated. So, oh, it shows a frame already. I knew it was doing that. Where did it choose this frame? Well, I guess it goes back. Okay, so what name got? Are you gonna pass in name two? Name here is already fire two. Oh, that's right. Create entity. Oh, it's render.anim. I already did this, huh? Yeah. Render.anim. It just lets it go. Otherwise, it uses render.image. Yes, that's a much better way to do it. Oh, sweet. Okay, so I just can call render.anim 5% D. Yeah, that's just my thoughts too, you know, like I don't know if how much that helps or what, but yay, look at that. We have a fire animation once again, but it's the wrong speed. Set an NM delay. So, what's the default delay? I guess it would be in the fire entity. 0.0618. So that'll be a render component. Render component where it's loading, creating the sprite, getting all its properties. Oh, wait, where it actually runs the animation. Yeah, we need to expand this function so it can take a delay. So the default delay, it's always going to be 0.1, but yeah, delay. All right, pizza, see you, man, later. Yeah, so this has a float delay and animate action. Animate set delay per something. What's up, Lime Studios? How's it going? Oh no, it's a NIM. Oh, I didn't need to, oh, didn't even need to call that or recompile any of this. Well, shoot, let's do this over. Writing component. Don't need that. Recompile. All right, so CC animate. Oh, damn, this, we don't have the actual delay here in this function. So we're creating the animate, and then it's a child of the repeat forever. Sprite runs the action, K action animate. I think this is possible. I think we can do this. All right, so. Opacity, additive blending, flash animation flags. Last thing, this is going to be set the animation delay. So, a pizza leaves and a lime enters. No, you're not banned. Excellent. You've already played an unhealthy amount of The Witness. So how are you? What's your take on The Witness? We got some other takes on The Witness earlier in the stream. No, I haven't really missed anything good. I've just been coding, really just coding the whole time. I haven't even drawn any walls yet. I want to draw some walls, but hopefully this I can get this finished. Really? Whoa, nice. Most enjoyable games ever played. Top three. Right on. It's cool to find that connection, right? Find that game that really like moves you that much. I love that. That happened to me last year with Axiom Verge. So if we have an NM delay, I'm gonna look up, find this thing's animation. It's already created the sprite. It's already started running this animation. This is kind of a backwards way to doing this. It kind of is. Forces you to really stop and smell the flowers. Focus on every detail. Love that kind of stuff. Nice, cool. I don't know. I think I'll let those people speak for themselves. Yeah, this is really backwards to do it this way, to create an animation before CC animate thing. There's only one case where it allows it to run that CC animation thing, and that's when it loads NM. It's an area creation. There we go. And in. No. Where did I put that? An in. Nothing. Image. What the heck happened to that code I was just looking at? Oh, I'm so confused. I thought it was image and an M. Render component. There it is. Oh, render.nm, render.image, of course. Okay. And okay, so if it has a render.nm, it just allows it to go create the entity. Yeah, I saw the indie box for Axiom Verge. It looks so sweet. Video game museum today. Whoa. Wow, it was at the top of the Steam sales, huh? Just pre-orders. Nice. Yeah, hopefully Asan, we can bring her indie box. That'd be cool. Work with those guys. Man, I've been stuck in this code land a little bit too long. I'm just going to do this way. So if it has an M delay. Actually, oh, I know what I could do. Instead of running the animation here, I could get it later. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, wait, this will probably break some old things. Break. I don't want to break old things to do something new. Unless I know this is right. Yeah, let's just keep it how that is for now. And then. Action equals sprite.getChild. No, get action by tag. K tag. K action animate. action is not equal to null. Auto child equals action dot get. I just gotta loop over every child for auto child in action get children. Dude, I feel like I wrote a method for this somewhere. Oh, actions don't have children. That's right. What is the action get target? How do I get the next action? Man, I don't even know. Ugh. Ah. Yeah, what's up, Seas Trampy? Yeah, it is kind of encouraging to see those high price points, right? Oh, I got it. I got it. I got it. Easy solution. All right. So anim will be something where it'll run it twice. So basically just run it twice. So easy. Get child. Anim. Get stir. So basically what I'm doing here, I'm writing a little function that loads, I'm basically writing code that makes the lights all load from data. And so I'm loading something to do an animation better from data. Right? Like puzzles, not a huge fan of tedium, right? I know, yes. It is a big problem in our game industry with mobile games at $1 or $2. It's a huge problem for us as game developers because we don't make shit for years worth of our lives putting into games. Yeah, that's true, right? Hardboiled paid 64. Man, there were people in the Kickstarter that paid 128 more, and they got cool posters too. I'm thinking for the game's release, maybe it'll be a cloth map. That was one thing people were requesting. I think, what was his name? I forget his name. Anyways. Right, yeah. Kickstarter is a little different. Yeah. Because you get more rewards and stuff. All right, I gotta focus here. Get this done. Kit animate anim with anim stir. If anim delay is less than zero, less than or equal to zero, anim delay equals 0.1. All right, so now we got an animation and. If anim dot get Your frame's on size less than or equal to zero, or is greater than zero. Then we're gonna, we have the ability to run all this animation. So anim.setDelay per unit to be an anim_delay. And then sprite stop all actions. Sprite run action. Oh, this is where we go. This CC animate anim, which technically should stop all actions, but not necessarily. Okay, that was a long bit of coding just to do one little thing. All I wanted to do is take the zero light here, this child of it, and make it so it had an animation delay. This should work, and also this should work now. I think. Oh no, that's not gonna work. Oh yeah, yeah, I should. doesn't work. Damn. So wait a minute, those Steam keys, don't they have to actually have played the game? I think the way Steam Spy works is it actually scans the people's accounts for what games they have. So if they've bought it on Humble Bundle and then they have the key but they haven't actually inputted it into Steam and added it to their library, then Steam Spy is not going to reflect that. So I can see why it would take a week, because if he's got all these pre-orders on Humble Bundle and nobody's gone and actually put it in their library, they haven't gone and actually played it yet because maybe it's, you know, not the weekend or whatever, then yeah, I can definitely see it, his numbers being a lot lower than... Because I'm the same way. Sombringer has a lot of pre-orders on Humble Bundle. So, you know, that's definitely factors into it. What if this was percent D? Would that just suddenly work? Yes, it suddenly worked. Oh. So it looks like it has to have the percent D. But I don't like that percent D. Ugh. Oh, he'll keep making games. Dude, he's going to do well with this game. Even if it really is only 6,000 sales, I'm sure he's got a lot of people working on his project or whatever, but if that's 6,000 sales times 40 bucks times industry average 0.7, that's 168 grand just in the first, what, day of it being out. I'm sure he's going to get up there past a million with this game. And I would guess he probably hasn't spent a million to make it. So I don't know. It could be total bullshit right there. I have no idea if that's right. But he'll do all right. I'm pretty sure he'll do all right. Skeleton. Oh yeah, the skeletons are new. Yeah. Oh, he went all in, really? Oh, okay. He spent a few million. Oh. Ah, I did not know that. Okay, yeah. All right, well, he's on track. I mean, it's on PlayStation. 6 years? Oh, I didn't know he's been making it for a whole 6 years. Wow. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, his braid, right? Wow, so he's got a lot of ground to cover. Well, I think he could do it. No wonder he's charging $40. It's a good thing for the industry too. Let's see one thing. If I change the delay now to make it really slow. Yeah. Yes, right. This is the way I make my own art. Also, if there's no way I can afford paying people that much. I can barely pay $1,500 a month just to keep myself developing. But I do, and it's all thanks to you people pre-ordering the game and the Kickstarter. Okay, we have an animation. I would like this to be a pound sign, though. So, area creation. Once again, I've lost that. Where the hell was that? Oh, render.nm, render.nm. Yes. Oh yeah, this should work. Okay. So back in render component, why is this not working? Render kit an imster with an entity with a pound sign in it. Didn't even hit that breakpoint. What? Render, nm, fire. Maybe it didn't have an image. Aha! Yay, oh, but it didn't animate. Damn you. Oh, didn't load that animation with the pounds. Okay, maybe I just didn't write the NM with the pound yet. Yeah, oh, here it is. Okay. Oops, this is supposed to be string. So I'm going to create a new string and then format it with the pound sign. So it's replace. I know, I think I wrote a function called replace string. Think it's just called replace, actually. Yeah, just replace. I don't know why that never comes up in my autocomplete. Subject character string. Bam. That's all we need. Replace subject s character pound. Replace with. There we go. All right. Let's see if that works. Lazy Shark starts in Feb 2010. There were 7 people working on it then. Wow. Oh, nice, dude. I like your style. Cool. Nice. Way to. That, I like those option settings too. Right on. I like your negative logo with the outside of the lime. That's cool. Nice. Right on. I know, with 10 frames a second, yeah. Sweet. So I'm just gonna step through this and it should load this animation now. Count sprite frames, max is 6, cool. Guys, less than max, string. So now we should have S, fire 0, bam, it worked. Push it back. Fire 1. Push it back. Cool, this is working. Yeah. Yes! It worked! It worked! Joy, jubilation! Okay, the next thing. This entity, I'm not sure if it needs this fire 0 anymore. Yeah, Salad Dogs, what's up? Yep. Yeah, a lot of people are streaming it. Definitely, it's on my homepage had it as well. Okay, so you do need one of these. You can fix that too. So a render component can be loaded from either image or NM. Oh, I think it just needs this. If it contains a name, percent, or pound. Yes. Wait. Did I do that right? Did I get the data right now? Oh, lost in my own code. Lost, I tell you. Model, cool. Yeah. Right on. She's awesome. Comment everything. Yes. Who needs comments? Yes, it worked. We finally have flickering fire running straight from data, pure data. It loads this child fire entity. So, all right, this is super awesome. And I didn't have to break the existing render component to do it. So, back, all the way back, area creation, when it's creating these lights, it's actually called create fire right now. It loads this profile, blah, blah, blah. Additive fire false, ooh, we're gonna need a particles as well. Next up, particles. And if, well, that's actually the next thing that would be really nice is to do an additive version of the same thing. So the additive version does blend funk additive, opacity zero. Does an action step. We can do that. Yeah, so action step. Back in render component, actually, there's set data with pause. That gives us a position. And step the animation right here. So that if it has render.nm, we can grab the action. So that's going to be auto action equals. Actually, no, we just grab the whatever animation it already has that's running. The internet can't lie. Ah. That's awesome. That was so good. Man, I was totally intending on doing pixel art today, but I think I'm using all my time for this. But, you know, this is worth it. I got to do this code anyways. Oh, it's render. Render.sprite. Dot get action by tag k action animate. If we have an action, action is not equal to null pointer. Then we do this steppy action, which basically just makes it so that the sum of the flames will flicker at a certain rate and some will flicker at a different rate. So world area get random one based on the thing's position. Get rand. Why don't you like this? Oh, we also need the anim's duration. Damn. I don't even know if that'll work, actually. Who cares? Let's not even add that. Let's just do world area. Get rand. Why am I getting rands? Liquid drum and bass. I love drum and bass. Oh, wait, is this music something that could get the video flagged? Oh, I better pause this. I don't know if that guy... Is that copyrighted music? Wants me to sign in to watch that one. Okay, I need to put this. Does this actually step the animation or the parent repeat forever? Animate, repeat forever. If not the animate, then how the hell do you get a child animate, child action Cocos 3DX? One thing I have no idea how to do. And how to get the animate child, to get that child action. All right, that's basically how that code would work, to do a step. But I don't care if it works. There we got a flicker. Scale. We just need scale now. One more piece of data. Scale. Shouldn't get the video flag, no. He's trying to sabotage. He's not with a publisher. Alright. Child, oh, Steve, you know this stuff. You do. Oh, how would I go in Cocos 2DX? If I have an action that is running another action, for example, a repeat action that is running an animation action, or a repeat forever action that's running an animate, how would I get the animate action inside the repeat forever action or whatever? Because I know I can definitely get this repeat forever out on the top, but then the animate on the inside or whatever, I have no idea how to access that. Get interaction? Oh, it's so simple, so beautiful. Now I just gotta find that code I was working on. Stepping, oh yeah, it's right here. An M step, all right. So the action. Get interaction? Come on, baby, work. Inner. No? Doesn't like it? Oh, maybe that's because it's not a finite action or whatever. I gotta cast this first. Yeah, so what kind of action does this return? It returns a regular action. I wanna do a... this is a repeat forever. Make the thing work. Yeah, cast a repeat forever. All right, yeah. I'll just do that. Dynamic cast. Repeat forever. There, checked it. All right, so, and then it would be... Action, get interaction. Oh, this is so awesome. Oh, you're a saint, Steve Tranby. All right. So there, now I'm getting the inner action. It's the inner action. Action is not equal to null pointer. Oh, wait. Yeah, I can't just do that. Okay, so action is action, get interaction, or repeat, get interaction. This is easy. If repeat's not equal to null. There, so it's nice contained on two lines now. Yes, yeah, thank you. There's probably other people watching on YouTube at some point that are going to be thanking you too. How do you do that? Oh, here's how. Here's how, just like this. Bam! Okay, so that should step the actions randomly. Let's see if we hit this. Let's see if we hit that breakpoint. This is if it has a repeat forever, that's get action mode tag, key action animate. This should work. Bam! For sure. Thank you. Thank you. Get interaction. Get interaction. It's even fun to say. Spice Weasel. Oh, by the way, Steve Tranby, your character that for the game, I'm getting maybe a month or two away from creating him. Maybe even sooner. Maybe during that. Because they're... The whole ship Songbringer is going to be full of characters, and there's also going to be room in the overworld for NPCs too. So definitely we'll work together soon on what you want your character to be. And if you guys are wondering what we're talking about, there's a bunch of people that backed at the Kickstarter and backed at a high enough level to get their, to design their own NPC. Bam it again, Elzar. Oh yeah, this guy, bam.
Every now and then you want to knock it up a notch with a blast from your Spice Weasel.
Spice Weasel for sure. Yes, look, it worked. So the pause of this is 8-6. Stepping it, let's see how, what it gets from the one rand F. Oh, I could even get the duration of the animation. .66, all right. Yeah, actually, I'll multiply this by that. Animate action. Dynamic cast, animate pointer. Repeat get interaction. Sweet! Successfully dug inside of another action. And then, so this is world. This is the enims, or the action, get duration, times world, get random, blah, 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 blah. So all of that basically will make the two flames flicker differently. That's all it's supposed to do. You demand a hidden lime in the world. Yeah, really? Nice. Well, if you really want to, I mean, if you got the cash, you can always upgrade on PayPal or whatever. I know you already got the game at some level, so like you can just PayPal me the difference, and you can create your own NPC. I'd be open to do that if you're open to do that. Yes, look, they're flickering differently. Oh, that's awesome. So one of them is a little off. Yes, yes, yes. That's awesome. And also, we should flip X. Oh, that's great. I can't believe that worked. That's rad. Hope you like Star Wars. My last email is filled with references. Nice. Right on. What's up, Sunset Kite? I'm doing good, man. Coconut in the desert. Yeah. And inside's a lime. How am I deciding where these data-driven lights go? That's actually decided with the patterns. So the patterns are not entirely data-driven. They're all code-driven. So, just the data. The data is how everything's expressed for the entity and what's part of it and all that. But then the patterns actually place the lights and place the other tiles. Okay, so the next step in this awesome process, making things more data-driven, is to go back to create fire and do the next little bit. The pattern is like the levels pattern, right? So there's lots of different patterns. There's a pattern for the entrance. This is an entrance to a dungeon that was supposed to be this is a different dungeon, huh? Yeah, this pattern right here is a pattern that's just dedicated to the entrance. So it's got this entrance tile here. It's got walls around it. It connects up the maze depending on different, you know, if it has wall like doors. So yeah, the pattern for the entrance for level one at least always has some fire right here or some lights. Yeah, no worries, man, no worries. Okay, so the next bit, it does this now, or wait, fire. Oh yeah, we could do an additive fire too. Yeah, let's do the additive version. Entities. Okay, so this is a zero light. It's got one child is the fire. The next child is the additive fire, which adds this cool glow. So same animation delay, Z order, didn't really matter. And then additive, and it's probably gonna need a different anchor point, but let's see what it's like first. Oh, the disposition actually is all it really needs to change. What? Oh, it didn't scale. It needs a scale. And I think it needs to go below. Let's see what the other one already did. So additive fire. This is 1000 minus light pause plus 29. And the regular fire, what was that? Oh, did I already delete it? I already killed it. Oh, wait. No. It's this. Oh, it also needs opacity. That's right. Yeah, it just needs to flicker its opacity from 64 to 80 and also give a scale. So render components need to process their scale. Yes, references, yes. I love hidden Easter eggy things. So fun. Really fun to find. Scale. Scale string. So I'm going to parse out scale equals parse vector, scale string, scale like blah, 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 blah. Yeah, this could be a comma. Scale.x is greater than 0. Scale dot y is greater than 0. Oh, just not equal to 0. These could be negative, technically. Negative is just a flipping of the sprite. All right, this sprite dot set scale. Scale at x, scale at y. They're funny and it makes you think you know something, right? Why did your intelligence and good sense go slow? Oh man, that happened to my Xcode. Emacs gnomes? What does parse vector do if it can't find two? Oh, it sets them both to be the same thing. Perfect. That's exactly what I wanted. Yes. All right. Okay, this should work too. So now we have a scale factor built into the data. So we can change this thing to be like scale 1.2. By, let's do really crazy tall, like 2. Nice song. Hey, look, it worked. See, we have this tall, flickering flame. That's kind of cool looking with it taller like that. So let's do really wide, like 1.5 wide. Yeah, right? That's all the pillars were. Oh, and it needs an anchor. So the anchor needs to change a little bit. Based on the scale. So if it's anchor, just position actually. No, yeah. So this can just change it to like 22. Yeah, let's see it more opacity so we can see obviously how big it is. Yeah, so for anybody joining the stream just recently, I'm working on making these lights data-driven so that it's very easy for me to go switch to a new dungeon and change a little bit of data, and it can have totally different kind of lights. That's looking pretty cool. I like how bright that is, actually. And I believe the other light, and you can see clearly that one of them is flickering in you know, without the other. So yes, this is having all of its own old features are put in, but all just expressed through data. Steve, is our conversation about references. All right, next up. Yeah, light data, right. Light data is reference for the whole dungeon. So you saw me editing right here in entities, right? The zero is the default or the overworld, right? So this is what a light always looks like in the overworld and by default in any dungeon that doesn't have a light definition. But here's a definition for another dungeon for light, which is the light for the fourth dungeon style or whatever, and I'll do something totally different there. Lost my place again. Just create fire. This doesn't work. So yeah, we got additive fire. This is actually all working. Oh, except for the flicker. We can add a flicker. So yeah, it doesn't need a profile component. It does a render component just fine. It sets its position fine, the blend func, opacity, alias parameters, the animation runs, the animation steps. Now we just need this flicker. Make this flicker data. Curious what we're modding later, yeah. I think this might even be the exact same Flickr data. I saw a game that promises to be completely data-driven, so, wow, that's awesome. Dude, that's rad. Guy was joking that essentially they are recreating RPG Maker in Unity. Whoa. Silver Quest Gaiden. It loads and understands external files in order to create the game. All the data is XML and ping. Wow, that's cool. Really, this is man, props to these guys. Props, big props. That's really cool. That excites me seeing that, right? That's so cool. Just express everything with data. Salad dongs. No, nope. That's Valtry. Yeah, yeah. They're totally public. You said, ah, oh, so they are. Was it difficult to develop Valtry? No, not at all. It's a very simple little, two files. All it is two files. Very simple data format. It just loads all this. I made sure, the only thing that was kind of difficult was just making sure it ran really fast. And that was just, you know, optimizing it so it doesn't split strings. It just uses string positions. Like basically just kind of operates almost in a C string kind of fashion, which makes it wicked fast for processing like everything. Yes, yes, I did develop Valtry. Yes. Yep. I developed Valtry and Entity Foo and Rabbit Game. All the stuff I'm using to create Songbringer, I've released a lot of it to be open source. Okay, so 64. Oh, this is just a more opaque Flickr, basically. 64. That's 0.25. Duh. 80, what's that going to be? 80 is going to be like 0.3. 0.313. All right, and we got 1.68, 1.707 for the X flicker. 1.68, 1.707, same thing. And I think this 252, 168, 50 is the exact same color we already have. So there, now we got a flicker data for this regular light. Why is it not foo tree? Man, it really should be. Or tree foo. Totally. God, it should be tree foo. And then the other thing should be rapid foo. Or maybe just X foo, Cocoa City X foo. Is it flickering that? Let's make it really obvious how it's flickering. So we'll make it flicker huge on just the X. It's a tree of values, not a tree of foos. Oh, this is not running it. It didn't run that. Why didn't it run a flicker action? Does not seem right. Build foo. You don't want to know. What is the foo? What is a foo? I actually got a total definition on what is a foo from a native Chinese speaker. And basically, foo has many meanings. None of them are what I thought they were. So I thought kung fu meant strength of your martial skill or whatever. I don't know. Foo, I thought foo meant strength. But foo does not actually mean strength, but it does mean man. So foo does mean just regular old man. Foo means, there's a bunch of other definitions that have to do with like, they're sort of male things, but I don't know. I don't even really know what foo means. Oh wait, dictionary reference has a foo? Foo marijuana, really? I've never heard that before. And I would have thought I was a pretty knowledgeable person about my marijuana references. Oh, fouled up. Yes, yes. Okay, so something's wrong with this flicker. It's not running this flicker for the child. Maybe it's not. Okay, let's, if we turn off that flicker. In its original meaning, kung fu can refer to any skill achieved through hard work and practice, not necessarily martial arts. Hmm. Oh. No, no. Yeah, it should be fine. It should be just a it's a child of the render. There. Duh. Really? Oh, we got an English Stack Exchange on foo. Wow. Yes, look at the flickers working now with that light. It's really weird looking. Can anyone tell me what the suffix foo stands for in the following sentence? It stands for advanced skill. There are lots of similar constructions such as script foo, Google foo. See? See, this is a totally different definition than what the native Chinese speaker told me. That's good. But this is what I thought it meant, right? Your advanced skill. Prefecture. Prefecture, right? Yeah. It wasn't really mean in prefecture. There. Also very different than marijuana. Yes. Hey, look at this. We got the... Okay, so now the lights are looking a lot like they used to. There's a couple problems still. I think the data, it needs to be able to hurt the player if you're standing on it. All right, we can get rid of this. Okay, so did I do everything? Yeah. All that's done. Additive fire, completely data driven. Sweet. Next up is the regular fire. So this regular fire, I'm not even doing this right now. Great. But oh, we do need particles. Particles, let's do the particles next. Right, some of the confusion comes from Mandarin being a tonal. Yeah, Cantonese is totally tonal as well. So you have a lot of homonyms, word sounds that mean different things. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. That's why the Chinese speaker told me that there's like four different meanings for foo, because it just depends on whether you say foo, 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 you know. Where's Pedro with the 2 hour notes? Is it 2 hours already? I am getting hungry. But let's do some, I'll do some particles before I go. Particles, we're missing these. So this is where the, it had these smoke particles. And this is pretty simple to parse this. Render component. Can parse out some particles. What's up, Hardline? Yes, born a snipe. Nice commit message. All right, so particles is this long ass. Look at that, look how long that is. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab this, the data string for this, or the data entity, parse out the different things. Particles. Particles. All right, so we need a kind, int kind equals 0. You're gonna need a particles kinds. Yes, I know, right? But it's true. Hey, what's up, Rocket Bunny? Oh no, I hate it when you have a problem you can't solve in your code. Oh no. So we need some special words. Constants dot h. Particle types. Constants.cpp. Particle types. What particles do we have again? Particles, K, blah, blah, blah. It's like, what? You can't spell particles like that. You can't do that. Kind, random, smoke, waterfall, river. None of those are really what they sound like, actually. Particles, K, kind, random. We have four of these types for now. Random, smoke, waterfall, river, random, smoke, waterfall, river. There, now we can parse these. Going back to render component, now we can go int kind equals kit parse flags. I worked on the ant people this morning. So here's what the ants look like kind of now. Let me turn this thing. I'm thinking they might have this sort of like energy beam they could shoot. So that's one ant. There's a bunch of other ants I'm drawing and stuff. I'm working on color schemes for their level. But yeah, I'll show you what I got so far in a second. Float width height. I guess it would be like 1 1 to start with, and then we would go parse. Area, what's it parse? Block size, there it is. Particles get child size. This is great because now it's gonna be block sized. Parse that into a V3F, that's right, V3F size. So now we got a vec. Parse vector. Back delimiter, comma. Wild cinder blocks, gotta bring him back. Oh, if the ant people in the desert had a raincoat. Yeah. The robe is a raincoat, right? Yeah. Speed. Density, fade duration, particle scale, all these are easy. Density. Fade duration, particle scale. And the next thing is the opacity range. Wait, where's that scale? Yeah, it's just opacity range and a bunch of colors. We're gonna have up to three colors, opacity range, parsed like this. And the colors. This time we're going to parse colors by comma, though. There's three of them. It's not really a range anymore. Color sirs, colors eye. Bam! We got everything. Everything we need. Okay, so particles dot or create. Opinions on this brick texture. It's really hard to tell an opinion on a texture until you see it in its context. I don't know, I would want to see a whole screenshot of your game with that in it first before you make any calls. If the streams are game dev related, I think you're better here on Twitch, thanks to the creative gallery. But the remaining types of programming, I think live coding TV is the best choice. I haven't tried live coding or the other one, Hitbox or whatever. Yeah, I hope that helps, salad dongs. Kind width is going to be the size dot width, size dot x, size dot y, vec, speed, density, fade, duration, particle scale, opacity range dot x, opacity range dot y. Whoa. Oh, there's a mid opacity. Forgot about the mid opacity. Okay, I can just make a V3F for that then. And that's pretty easy. You go capacity range dot set. You can pass in a string. So Flickr get child opacity get string. You can also pass in your delimiter character, and the delimiter character is now going to be a comma because there's three. Okay, great. So now we got opacity range dot x dot y dot z. Color min is going to be colors 0, colors 1, colors 2, and the parent is render.sprite. Ooh, that's a lot of code. Right, render.sprite, is that right? Oh no, this is just sprite. Okay. Oh wait, this is particles, not Flickr. All right, let's see if this works. Did I ever get into the game dev with Slack Bell, Zach Bell? Yes, I did. I've only visited it once though. What, your school's at 7:30 in the morning now? What's up with that? Nah, Rocket Buddy, cool schedule. Uh-huh, sweet. Yeah, good, I'm glad you're meeting people on that. Like crazy good or crazy bad? Right now, this fire entity, I want to have some particles. Particles. And it's going to be confusing if I don't just load everything from the strings. There's kind, smoke, size. The old thing was sprite.getContentSize.width times 0.68, 618, which was the old. The old width and height of the fire, which is common fire 0. The content size would have been 24. Multiply that by 0.6. Whoops. Ah. 14.8. Size is going to be 14. 15 by 15. Oh, wait, no. This is right. Sprite gets on this width. 41 times an inscale, that's just 41. 15, 42. 42! You're a bat now. Nice. You met one of the main guys on CD Projekt Red's team? Cool. Whoa, hard-boiled. You're using JGrasp on in class? What's JGrasp? Vec. 0.1. Speed. 0.3. This is gonna be speed, density, fade duration, particle scale, opacity, color. All right, so density is 1, fade duration 1, particle scale 2, opacity 1, 1, 20, 20 over 255 is 0.078. Color. Got a bunch of colors here. This is kind of really changing color. Someone say 42? Oh, they're the guys behind The Witcher? Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That's amazing. Oh, cool. Hardline. 231, 207, 44. 231. What was it? 207. Color. It's gonna be that. 231, 207, 44. Same thing. And the last color is 158, 105, 31. There. See if that worked. We should have particles coming off of the fire if this works. Right? Why are you even talking? But he was. Okay, so something happened. Something went wrong because it's not having any flickering particles coming off of the flames. Render particles. It should, yeah. Let's go to render components, see if we're even getting that far. Get in here. Oh, must stay awake. I'm having trouble staying awake too, man. It's like only 5 p.m. for me. Yeah, the skeleton eyes flickering red. Did it parse that right? Kind. What is kind? Kind is zero. I guess it's probably not right. Parse block size into size. Size is currently probably. Just 1,000, 1,000. Oh, yes, 1542. Sweet. Wait. K particles types. Smoke, K kind smoke. K kind random. Waterfall. These look proper. But that should have been a one. Kind should be one. Three 35, 735. You're five. I know. Oh Yep, I'm being a pussy right now. Total pussy. Yeah. Parse flags. Kind. Should be right. So we get child, get string, parse flags. So the string we're parsing is smoke. The words we have, we should have a few of them. Being added. No, this is the wrong, totally the wrong thing. Oh, I must have done something wrong in constants. Constants.cpp. No? Got K light flags, K particle types. These are totally separate. This is K particle types. Oh man, you know what? I probably got to do a clean build. What's up, clock? Null is definitely fine. I'm gonna cook a big dinner. That's what I'm gonna do. What's the difference between a regular build and a clean build? Oh, not a stupid question. Okay, what the way that compilers work and stuff is they take your source code, all this text and stuff you've typed, it's code, and then they compile it into object files and all these temporary build files, libraries, object files, static libraries, shared library, all these little files, right? And then it and finally takes those temporary files and puts them together into a final built executable file or whatever the executable package is on that kind of platform. And so what a clean build is it takes all those intermediate temporary files that you created in the process and it deletes them all so that you can start over fresh and recompile everything. Because what I think just happened here is that it didn't recompile the constants, because this was some wicked voodoo. Something was just, you know, I was referencing this type and it was doing a different type. So that's voodoo, man. When you see voodoo, like just crazy stuff you can't understand, it sometimes it has to do with doing a clean build. Well, I'll be over for dinner in an hour. Up on your planes. Will it be a potluck? Yeah, I'm doing all the cooking, man. All of it. Through trouble, we found out yesterday that I'm only a non-coder here, right? That makes you special. Totally unique. So in kind now should be one. It is! See, it was total voodoo. I told you it was voodoo. And then parse block vector size. Sizes was fine last time. Vec speed 0.3. Density should be 1. Particle scale. Yep. The only problem is color stirs. Opacity range. Oh, opacity range is all 0 too. Come on, so close to having this working. Opacity 1.0, 1.0, color, blah, 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 blah. These are commas. That's right. You bringing the limes and the coconuts? Perfect. Foul tree, get child. Opacity range. Come on, opacity range. You're the net. You're the last bit. All you gotta do is work. String's empty. That's why. Flicker. Particles. Particles. Duh. Come on. Okay, so now we should have some particles. This time it's gonna work. I got a feeling. You can make some amazing ren beads and rice. Sweet. Yes. Damn. No particles still. What? Okay, what data did not get populated? Dude, I'm sold too. Man, this is making me hungry right now. Which I am trying to get going here, but I just really wanted this to work before I went. Okay, so one. Size is important, of course. Size is 15 by 42. That looks good. Vec 0, 1. That's good. Speed 0.3. Density 1. Fade duration 1. Particle scale 2. Opacity range. This one's really important. Yeah, we got a 1, 1. 0.078. That's good. Colors, these are also important. If they're black, they won't be seen. Color strings, that got parsed correctly, so probably colors is good. Colors. Oh, it's right there. Yep. 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 So what? Why didn't it work? So it is based on the, maybe it's based on the parents. So you can split the gas. I know. I probably am too hungry to think. Right, yeah, there should only be one operating system. I agree, man. Too many operating systems. Hey, even its parent size is all right. All right, so we should also get this on enter function. All right, parent scale matters. Whoa, this is really unsafe. They turned out all right. Create moats. total. Here's a really important one. Width times inverse tile width times density times height times inverse tile height times density. This thing's width and height, they're fine. Inverse tile width, tile height, those look okay. Density, the other most important thing. One, should be totally fine. We should have a total, a lot of total product. Total three. It's not a lot, but I don't know. I don't know why it's not working. Oh well. Yeah, no, no particles. It's not working for some reason. They're, you know, they should be. They're so close. But it's just not quite drawing these particles. I don't know where they are, what they're doing. The particles are taking a break right now. That's what they're doing. What? Rocket Bunny! All right, guys. Well, yeah. Let me show you what I was working on for the rest of the night. I'm working on this other dungeon. So I just spent the whole stream doing data-driven lights. I was gonna draw some walls, but for the rest of the night, I'll have to work on walls and stuff. So here's kind of a start to this ant dungeon. It's gonna be totally different. These lights are not really gonna look like this, I don't think. And these statues will look a lot different too. I'm thinking the whole area might be a little lighter in all aspects. And so next I need to draw some walls. It's not just these empty entities right here. Yep, but that's it. That's all for today's stream, guys. Have a good night. Yeah, it's just no doubles, Rocket Bunny, no doubles. But it's all in jest, all in jest. So have a great night, guys. Stop that. Stop the hate.